As people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because they have rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
Because you rejected knowledge, I will reject Jesus.
But Lord, help me. No. That's just like some of these women that reject the basic understanding of what women should do. They don't have a man. Men continually reject you. They'll have sex with you a couple times, but when it comes down to time to really commit to you, what do? They leave your ass. They leave you. Now, realizing that's a curse, but guess what? A man of understanding will stick around with that woman. But first off, a man of understanding will choose a woman that's worth something in the first place. What did you say right after that?
When you look at it in the spiritual aspect about it, the Lord looked at Israel as the same way. Because we're the most honored one.
Yep.
You know?
So if we ain't right,
so we stuck on stupid and we ain't right and we, you know what I'm saying, behaving like strange other women, acting like hoes, worshiping other gods and all that.
Yep.
You think he gonna wanna stick around and wanna deal with you, man? I ain't fucking with this bitch. This bitch is crazy, man.
Right.
This bitch has no sense. What's wrong with her, man? She has no knowledge.
I walked them out of Egypt. I crossed the Red Sea with them. Took down every enemy that they had in front of them, and I gave them the greatest land in all the world. Yeah. And all they had to do was listen to what I told them, like they said they would do. Yeah. And ain't that how you? Now you just keep going back and forth. Your woman act just like this. As to her man, like Israel asked to the Most High.
Yep.
Rebellious, don't want to follow directions. And so you wonder why you end up single. That's why we out here single as Israelites. We out here single.
And that's why the Lord cursed us. The Lord, that's crazy. We go against the Lord, you know what I'm saying, as His women. The Lord gave us literal women that's going to go off.
Yep.
Just like we go off with Him. Our women gonna go off on us, man. You know, the Lord pretty much got us back with that. Pretty much, you know.
That thou shalt be no priest unto me, seeing thou hast forgotten.
Hey, the priest looks to like, what does the priest do? He takes care of the things of the Heavenly Father for the people, right? So you ain't gonna be connected to the Heavenly Father because you rejected knowledge. Yep. You know?
Seeing thou hast forgotten the laws of thy power.
And how did who? Because that's what the priests did. The Levites did that directly for our nation. They made sure we stayed connected with the law, which kept us connected to the Heavenly Father. Matter of fact, if you may go to get Wisdom of Solomon 6 and 12, I think that about this part. It might be lower than 12, like 17 or something. I think it's 12, though. When it talks about the order.
Seeing thou hast forgotten the laws of thy power, I will also forget thy children.
Uh-huh. You know what I'm talking about?
The wisdom of glory is the best place to live.
That's like lower, like 16, 17, maybe. I'm 12, right?
Yeah.
He's like 16 or 17.
Well, she calls about seeking such as Rosalind. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The very truth.
Right there. That's it right there.
Yeah. I'll start at 15. No. Wisdom of Solomon 6 and 15. To think therefore upon her is perfection of wisdom. And whoso watcheth for her shall quickly be without care.
Yeah.
For she goeth about seeking such as are worthy of.
Now, let's go back there. That's talking about Israel, and that's talking about wisdom, right? A man that seeks wisdom. Now let's put that analogy of the woman seeking a man. If she had wisdom or knowledge, she would be able to find a man. She would have quickly be without care because the Lord would deliver her to a man that's going to make sure these things are taken care of because he's going to have wisdom. He's going to deliver her to a man that has wisdom, who's going to keep both of them out of trouble and keep them connected to the Most High, which keeps you out of trouble and in wisdom. Keep going.
For she goeth about seeking such as are worthy of her, talking about wisdom,
yep, and, show for herself. Like, let me use the analogy, just like women only women that a good man gonna get with is a good woman. Because he's smart enough not to deal with these raggedy ass bitches that walk around nowadays out here. That throw their box around and it's all stinky and not and untaken care of. Kids is at home, all out of control or whatever else. Ain't no man want, no good man want that. Now there's nothing serious. Go ahead.
Show of herself favorably unto them in the ways and meeteth them in every thought.
Uh-huh.
For the very true beginning of her is the desire of discipline.
The very true beginning of wisdom is discipline. What's the number one thing our women don't act for? Let's go with the whole nation first. Our people don't have discipline. That's the number one problem with our people. We don't have discipline. We're too busy. Whatever makes us feel good, whatever makes us excited, whatever bright light, and you know, all of that's all we seek after, the simple shit. No discipline to stick to the Heavenly Father. We can't stick to a diet. We can't stick to working out. We can't stick to one man. We can't, I ain't gonna say stick to one woman. We can do that. Still says the Bible. But you know,
talking about these women, they can't stick to one man.
Right.
You know? They gotta have their heart's desire. They gotta have too much.
Uh-huh.
Instead of maintaining perfect balance in things, you know what I'm saying? She's more than excessive, just like her love when we saw.
Yep.
You know?
Can't stick to one God. But he's the only power out here. He's the most high God. The one and true power, the most powerful over everybody. Over everything. We can't stick to him. But we got him. That's another one. We're about to analogy to man and woman. A woman can have the best man there is. The best man that they could possibly get. And they won't look down on him because there might be one something that they don't like about him. But he's the best man that your ass is ever gonna get. And he's above the level that you're at, and he's gonna bring you to a higher level. You'll still disrespect that man and be looking at other men. I watched women on this trip walk up and down here with a good man. They both look like they got a little money or whatever. They look nice, whatever, you know. And the woman still be looking over like, what's better than this? Bitch, he just brought you to Vegas. Y'all probably staying in one of these nice-ass hotels or whatever. And you looking good out here. And you still looking at other men? No discipline. Our people have no discipline. You have no discipline at the dinner table. No discipline in your diet. You're going to eat whatever the TV tell you to eat. It's good. Whatever the white man eat, you're going to want to eat what he eat. You just have no discipline to follow after the one man, which is your husband, and for him to follow after the one power, which is the Yahweh Shemel Shah. Keep going, bro.
It says, and the care of discipline is love.
And the care of discipline is love. Because if you love something, you're going to stay disciplined with it. We love this. We love this Bible. We love this word. We love teaching this Bible. That's why we out here in the rain. If you really love something, you're going to do it rain, sleet, or snow. Sunshine, blazing heat, you're going to do it regardless. And that's what the men of the Lord do. We come out because we love to do it. We don't love you niggas that ignore us and fan the hand and laugh and mock. We don't. But we love the Heavenly Father who commanded us to do this though. We enjoy the job he gave us. Our lives would be nothing if it wasn't for this job. It'd be just as empty as the bullshit that y'all live and do, if not worse. You have something to go right now?
I got the definition of discipline. Okay. The definition of discipline. The practice of training people to obey rules or a code of behavior, using punishment to correct disobedience.
Yep.
Another
Are we being punished right now because we're disobedient to the Heavenly Father? That's why we went through slavery. The Negroes went through slavery, the Hispanics and everybody else went through slavery, and we're still in slavery today. You know, we're in slavery today. We get beat. We can't keep a job, we can't keep money. We can't grow a society.
Hey, going back to what you were saying about the women, because right here it says a synonym for discipline is control,
yep.
Training, instruction.
Yep.
Do your woman really want to be controlled? Do she want instruction?
Uh-huh.
Do she want to be trained? No,
hell
she
yeah.
Don't. She wants to do her own fucking thing, and she wants you to fall under her vibration.
Right. And the fucked up part about it is so twisted, she wants you to do, she wants you to want to do what she wants you to do.
Yep.
But she wants you to be thinking doing it. What kind of control is that? I want a man that's gonna love me, that's gonna want me to be the one and only thing he think about, the only woman in the world that's the greatest thing. Y'all want the dumbest shit. I can't focus on wisdom to take care of your ass if I'm thinking about you.
And Black A, and that dude Black Rim on YouTube, man, he hit it. With these women, man. She want all of these things, right? But look what you get out of it.
Right. Nasty ass box.
A nasty ass used up box. And she wants you to, when she gets with you, that's when she want all these qualities and all these, you know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. But all these other guys that ain't hit it and decked out, they hit it and ducked. You know what I'm saying? Yep. They didn't have to have those qualities. But when she got with you, she wanna switch it up.